Okay, you may begin to interest in Python. You may wanna code on your computer yourself. Okay, if you want that, just easy search Python and click on this Welcome to Python. Easy. Click on download. So we have many like releases of Python. I'm on Windows, so here Windows. They have Windows and Unix or Linux or Mac OS and other operating system. So this one is, I think, this is the most popular one here. So you can download here and install. So I have the caution for the installation. When you install it, here it's gonna be like this one. Remember to click this add Python or whatever version you download. Add Python to path. So so if you don't click on this, you likely cannot run any Python program in your on your computer. So if you miss to click this, there are a way to fix this. So okay, here it say that you can manually add Python into Windows. Oh, I forgot to mention that I'm on Windows. So you should find here it say that you oh yes it differs. You should find a Python containing folder. So I'm on PC. If you install it defaultly, it's gonna go on this user. That is me. And here you will not see Abdata like him. So you're gonna click on view here. Oops, and click hidden item. So it's gonna be here. It is hidden. You cannot see it. So hit the local programs. Why I don't have like him. Okay, sorry. If you find a file like this, it's not gonna be hard. It's not going to be hard, okay? And you're gonna go add path. So right click on PC, advanced system, environment, and go down here. You can see path here. You can edit and you can add the file directory of Python executor or compiler, something like that. The file containing folders. So click new and add here. I'm not going to be add, going to be add because I think I already have. No. Okay. So if it's not work, you should do like this. So let's get started. As I mentioned, you can like Google's Python tutorial because it's very popular language. There are many people willing to teach you to this incredible language. Oh, yeah, like a lot, but if you have a problem with English, I'm gonna recommend you this website, PyBlast Python. So click here. It's gonna be Thai, right? Click on Python. So you can here there are a lot of Python methods or commands. You can click and read. He writes really great. Yeah, Okay, but for English version, let's back to our days. Hardened syntax. Okay, if you are from C or Java or maybe another language, you might add it to how can I say? You might add it to do like this. If you from the printf something, oops, and semicolon. But in Python, you don't need semicolon. From this example, you can see print hello world. And it's gonna say hello world normally here. Okay, I'm gonna run it for you for example. Oops. Okay, maybe here. New item tree. I'll change this to maybe learn Python. Okay, see that? Print hello. Right. Gonna print hello a lot and control enter. Yeah, it's gonna say hello. So print something. Print, or you can maybe in Thai too. Here, something has a Thai. It support any language. Let's try on Japanese. Oh, okay, yeah. Let's try on this print. Yeah, it's Japanese. It's gonna print Japanese normally, no error. So, yeah. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna declare a variable like text. You don't have to be like SHA or something like in C or your mail string, something like that. You can declare any variable without any like syntax login or float, blah blah blah. It's equals. Oops. What? Okay. Test. I'm gonna print text here. Test easy. So we're gonna look at the indentation here. So Python is like the space sensitive language. In C, if you want to do if else, you're gonna do like if 5 more than 2. You have this bracket, right? You type and semicolon. But in Python, no. If 5 more than 2 and this colon, you hit enter, it's gonna be like tapped one time. So print like him 5 is greater than 2 and I hit, yeah, because 5 is yes, it's greater than 2. So it's gonna print here 5 greater than 2. But let's see if I remove the tab. If it's let's see if it's gonna be work. No, because here, yeah, let's see the error. Indentation error here, as he yes it said, as the website said, expected an indented box. So the indented box is a tab, one tab. Okay, if I tap one tab here and runs again, here it work normally. Python variables, as I mentioned, you don't have to declare to be an int, a float, or something like that. Okay, let's follow him. X equal 5. Okay, In C, you're gonna do like in ISO 5, right? But in Python, you don't have to. Oh, okay. Sorry, I didn't mention this. Sharp is like a comment. Commences have like in C is slash, right? Oops. Slash. My Python is tab. If you use Jupyter, you can let me test. You can control and hit the slash button to comment here. Okay, why is this easy? Comment, as I mentioned, this comment is a command. Okay, let's go next. Multi-line comment. Okay, you either do like here, blah blah blah, blah blah, or you can do like this is one of the like if you surf in the algorithm problem website, you're gonna see them writing in this form very much. So yeah, 2, 3. If you want it, you can type this multi-line comment. Oh,